Hello everyone. Today I'm going to continue with some of the problems, verbal problems on simultaneous linear equations. These are the problems from exercise 3.4. Now the first problem, if we add 1 to the numerator and subtract 1 from the denominator, a fraction reduces to 1. It becomes half if we only add 1 to the denominator. What is the fraction? So what should we do? Let the fraction be x by 1. So let the fraction be x by 1. So let us see. If we add 1 to the numerator, so x plus 1 divided by subtract 1 from the denominator, y minus 1, the fraction reduces to 1, is equal to 1. So, what do you get? X plus 1 cross multiplication is equal to y minus 1. Suppose you do x plus, see, x minus y is equal to minus 1 plus 1, you take the side, minus 1. So, x minus y is equal to minus 2. Call it as that equation 1. Now, go to the second one. What is that? It becomes half if we only add 1 to the denominator. So, x divided by y plus 1 is equal to half. It becomes half if we only add 1 to the denominator. So, again you cross multiply, you will get 2x is equal to y plus 1, or 2x minus y is equal to 1. You got two simultaneous linear equations, one as x minus y is equal to minus 2, another one is 2x minus y is equal to 1. Let us write one below the other and let us see whether we can eliminate x or we can eliminate y. So 2x minus y is equal to 1 and x minus y is equal to minus 2. If you look at y, both are 1 and 1. Coefficient are same, but both have got the same sign. I said whenever they are of the same sign, it is always you have to subtract. When you subtract, the sign changes. Minus, plus, plus. So 2x minus x, ax. Minus y plus y, 0. Is equal to 1 plus 2 is 3. So you get x is equal to 3. Now substitute this in any one of the equation. So x is equal to 3. 2x minus y is equal to 1. So 2 into 3 minus y is equal to 1. So 6 minus 1 is equal to 1. So y is equal to 5. So you understood? X is equal to 3 and y is equal to 5. So what is that fraction then? X by y is equal to 3 by 5. Am I right or wrong? 3 plus 1, how much? 4. Y minus 1, 5 minus 1, 4. 4 by 4 is 1. Yes, we are right. Another one. X divided by y plus 1. What is x? 3. 5 plus 1, 6. 3 by 6 is 1 by 2. We are right. So, whatever we worked out is very much correct. Now, let us go to the second question. The second question is, 5 years ago, Nuri was thrice as old as Sonu. 10 years later, Nuri will be twice as old as Sonu. How old are Nuri and Sonu? Nuri was thrice as old as Sonu. So who is older? Nuri is older than Sonu, right? Let Nuri's age be x. Nuri's age be x and Sonu be y. So, 5 years ago, Nuri x minus 5, Sonu y minus 5. Right? Now you relate. 5 years ago, Nuri was thrice as old as so no. X minus 5, okay? That was equal to 3 times y minus 5. Nuri was thrice as old as Sonu. Now, 10 years later, so 10 years later, x plus 10 and y plus 10. So, what is that given? Nuri will be twice as old as Sonu. Nuri's age is x plus 10 will be equal to 2 times y plus 10. See, these are the two important things to frame the equations. So, let us take this first one. What do we get? X minus 5 is equal to 3y minus 15. Or you get x minus 3y is equal to 5 minus 15, or x minus 3y is equal to minus 10. Call it as one. Another one, x plus 10 is equal to 2y plus 20, or x minus 2y is equal to 20 minus 10. So x minus 2y is equal to 10. So that is what you have got. So look at these both equations, write down together. X minus 3y is equal to minus 10. X minus 2y is equal to 10. Let us see this. You can eliminate x. So you can subtract minus plus minus. What do you get? X minus x 0. Minus 3y plus 2y minus 1y is equal to minus 20. So y is equal to 20. Once you get y is equal to 20, you can find out what is the value of x. You know, x minus 2y is equal to 10. So x minus 2 into 20 is equal to 10. So x is equal minus 40 is equal to 10. X is equal to 10 plus 40. How much? 50. So I can say Nuri's age is what? 50, and Sonu is 20. Let us see whether it is correct or not. Nuri's age 5 years ago was 45, and this one was 3 into 45. Is it 3 into 15? Yes, you are right. So that means Nuri's present age is 50 years and Sonu's present age is 20 years. Now let us move on to the third question. The next question is like this. The sum of digits of 2-digit number is 9. In a 2-digit number, let x and y be the digits. So what can I say? X plus y is equal to 9. Let me read the question again. The sum of the digits of 2-digit number is 9. And 9 times this number is twice the number obtained by reversing the order of the digits. Find the number. So digits I write down as x, y, but I don't write down the number. The general form of a 2-digit number is 10x plus y. While we read, we don't read 2, we read 22. While reading 3 and 2, we don't read 3, we read 32. So, how we have to write down a 2-digit number? We have to write down as 10x plus y. So, the sum of the digits x and y is equal to 9. Yes. So, the number is 10x plus y. So, 9 times 10x plus y is equal to twice the number obtained by reversing the order of the digits. So, 2 times 10y plus x. I am reversing the order of the digits. Then, 2 times. So, I simplify this. This is one equation. 90x plus 9y is equal to 20y plus 2x. So I get 90x minus 2x plus 9y minus 20y is equal to 0. Or 90x minus 2x, 88x minus 11y is equal to 0. So dividing by 11, you get 8x minus y is equal to 0. You got two equations. Try to solve these two equations. What are those? X plus y is equal to 19 and 8x minus y is equal to 0. So plus y minus y you can add. You get 9x is equal to 9. X is equal to 9 divided by 9 is equal to 1. So once you know x, let us see what is y. X plus y is equal to 9. So 9, x is 1 plus y is equal to 9. So y is equal to 9 minus 1 is equal to 8. So the number is 18. When you reverse it, 81. So let us see whether it's correct. Sum of the two digit number is 9. 9 times the number, 9 into, what is that number? 18. 9 18s are 162 is equal to 2 times 81. You are very much correct. So find the number. The number is 18. So 1 and 8, 18. So, let us move on to the next question. Next question is, Meena went to a bank to withdraw rupees 2000. She asked the cashier to give her rupees 50 and rupees 100 notes only. Meena got 25 notes in all. So, find the number of notes of rupees 50 and rupees 100. So, what should we do? Let the number of rupees 50 be x and 100 be y. So what can I write down? First one, x plus y is equal to 25. She got 50 rupees and 100 rupees notes together 25. Am I right? So what is the next one? She withdrew how much? Rupees 2000. So 50 rupees x notes plus 100 rupees y notes together cost rupees 2000. So you can divide it by 50. When you divide it by 50, what do you get? X plus 2y is equal to 40. This is the second equation. Let us write down the equation together. X plus y is equal to 25. X plus 2y is equal to 40. So you can eliminate x, subtract. X minus x 0, y minus 2y is minus y, is equal to minus 15. So y is equal to 15. Therefore, x plus y is equal to 25. Y is equal to x plus 15 is equal to 25. So x is equal to 25 minus 15 is equal to 10. So what is the number of notes of 50 rupees? 10. So is it correct? 15 into 10, 500. 15 into 100, 1500. So totally 2000. Yes, we are right. So I can say rupees 50 no more. 10 notes and rupees 100, 15 notes, totally 25 notes, and 10 into 50, 500, 15 into 100, 1500, together 2000. Now let us go to the last question of this exercise. Last question is, a lending library has a fixed charge for the first 3 days and an additional charge for the days thereafter. Sarita paid rupees 27 for a book for 7 days, while Susie paid rupees 21 for book for 5 days. Find the fixed charge and charge per day. What shall we do? Let the fixed charge be X. Fixed charge X and charge per day be Y. So, a lending library has a fixed charge for the first 3 days. So, what do you write down? X plus Sarita paid rupees 27 for 7 days. So, 3 and totally another 7 days. So, 4 days. 4 days she paid Y. Totally 27. Another one. Susie paid 21 rupees for 5 days. So, X, that is for 3 days, plus another 2 days. 2Y is equal to 21. So, now, directly you can eliminate the value of X and can find out the value of Y. And thus, you can get the value of X and Y. So, subtract minus, minus, minus. X minus X, 0. 4Y minus 2Y, 2Y is equal to 6. So, Y is equal to 6 by 2 is equal to 3. So, once you know Y, we can find out X. X plus 4Y is equal to 27. So, X plus 4 into 3 is equal to 27. X plus 12 is equal to 27. X is equal to 27 minus 12 is equal to 15. So, fixed charge X is equal to 15 and charge per day is 3. Are we right? Let us check. Is 15 plus 4 into 3? 12. It's 27? Yes. 15 plus 2 into 3? 6. Is equal to 21? Yes. I hope you understood how to frame the equations and solve the equations by any method. I used your elimination method to find out the unknown. So, I hope you understood. If you like my video, please share it with others and subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.